Hey, it's Dr. Huntington here, and let's talk about leaky gut, which is also known as intestinal permeability. Now, this condition is extremely common. It can lead to devastating health problems, yet most people who have it don't even know it. And what makes things worse is that most doctors don't understand the condition or don't know anything about it, and usually don't consider it when evaluating a sick patient. So it goes undetected in most cases, despite the fact that it can be the root cause of many diseases. So in this video, I'll show you some of the major signs that will tip you off to the fact that you might have a leaky gut. But don't get too down on yourself as we go through these symptoms, because there are solutions. And of course, a leaky gut is way more socially acceptable than a leaky butt.
What? But
we're gonna roll with it, right? But you're better off than that guy. All right, so the lining of your intestines should be tight so that only properly broken down nutrients in water can pass through and enter your body. But when junctions between the cells which line your gut loosen, or you develop gaps and holes like this, if you take a look here, this is the lining of the gut here, like we're cutting through a tube on both sides. You can see the lining on both sides, and the food travels through this way. And there's food and there's bacteria in here. There should be tight junctions between these cells, which are the squares, right? But what can happen is you end up with gaps, and that's where the food or bacteria exit, and they're not supposed to do that, and can make their way into your blood. Now, this allows like these particles, like I said, there's bacteria and toxins that should never leave your digestive tract to sneak through into your bloodstream. And that's why the condition is called leaky gut. This condition triggers like widespread inflammation and immune reactions in your body, and it can result in conditions that can be difficult, if not impossible, to reverse. So let's look at some of the signs of leaky gut. Now, if you have food sensitivities or allergies, there's a good chance your gut is leaky. And this is because the leaky gut allows foreign substances, such as undigested food particles, and bacteria, and toxins, into your bloodstream. And these trigger your immune system to attack those substances using something called antibodies, which are proteins that destroy foreign invaders. And this is both good and bad. I mean, it's good because these undigested food particles and bacteria and toxins are not supposed to be in your blood. So your immune system attacks them and gets rid of them. But it's bad because a leaky gut causes repeated, almost constant exposure to these foreign particles. And so your immune system actually becomes like hyper-stimulated. But there's another problem. And the problem is that your immune system has a memory. And so you can become sensitive or allergic to certain foods that you're eating routinely, and these develop symptoms and an immune response every time that you eat them, even long after the leaky gut has been repaired. And that's the basis for most food sensitivities. Now, some of the primary foods to contribute to this problem are foods that contain gluten and also dairy products, and that's why those two foods need to be eliminated when trying to heal a leaky gut. Now, food sensitivities are often at the root of symptoms like fatigue and headaches and joint pain, bloating and diarrhea, and skin conditions such as eczema and acne. So all these symptoms can be a sign of a leaky gut. Now, another warning sign is autoimmune disease. And this is when your body's immune response is directed at a specific tissue in your body, such as your thyroid gland or your muscle tissue. And this attack by your immune system causes dysfunction in that tissue. So examples would be like Hashimoto's disease and Graves' disease, which are both autoimmune diseases resulting from the body attacking the thyroid gland. And there are actually more than 100 different autoimmune conditions, including lupus and Crohn's disease and celiac and Hashimoto's and rheumatoid arthritis, and those being some of the most common. And remember, with autoimmunity, the tissue being destroyed is not the problem. The problem lies in the gut, you know, not the tissue or organ exhibiting the symptoms. Somewhere around 25 million Americans are diagnosed with an autoimmune disease. Right? And this number could be up to 50 million if you include the estimated numbers that go undiagnosed. And what's the primary trigger for these diseases? It's a diet high in sugar, high in unhealthy fats, and low in fiber. You know, this diet, it destroys the healthy bacteria and the enzymes in the lining in your gut, making it leaky. And that triggers inflammation and immune responses, you know, to the leaked particles. And those are at the root of many autoimmune diseases. Now, another warning sign, and a more obvious, like visible one, is skin issues like acne or eczema and psoriasis. In fact, the condition of your skin is a window into your gut health. You see, your skin is intended to be a physical, chemical, and antimicrobial defense system for your body. But inflammation in your gut, you know, resulting from like leaky gut, it actually destroys the protective function of the epidermal layer, which is the outermost layer of your skin. And this impairs its antimicrobial ability, making your skin prone to inflammation and infection. Another way a leaky gut contributes to skin problems is by preventing proper nutrient absorption. Remember, your skin is an organ, like it's your largest one, right? Making up about 10% of your body weight. And it needs nutrients to survive. And when nutrients are in short supply, your body will prioritize, you know, the nutrients to the essential organs, like your heart, your brain, and your liver. And so the less essential areas, such as your skin or your hair or your nails, they suffer without, you know, the full nutrients they otherwise would need. Now, cognitive disorders like autism and depression can also point to a leaky gut. And inflammation is again a common theme here. In this case, the inflammation triggers a class of chemicals called inflammatory cytokines. And elevated levels of these inflammatory cytokines are linked to depression and autism. All right, so to summarize, some of the common signs that you have a leaky gut include food sensitivities or allergies. And the signs of that you might have those would be like, you know, you get fatigue or headaches or joint pain, bloating or diarrhea or eczema. And the trouble here is that it's not always right after you eat. You know, sometimes it's a delayed reaction. Could be 24 hours later. Also, if you have an autoimmune disease, that's a sign you might have a leaky gut. Skin problems such as acne or eczema or psoriasis, and any sort of cognitive trouble. And the only known handling for a leaky gut lies in nutrition and changes to your diet. Handling all these other conditions, like the skin conditions or the joint pain, what happens is when you do that, it just masks the problem of the leaky gut. So check out some of my other videos for a full explanation of what dietary changes will help you to heal a leaky gut. And go to BodyManual.com and look at the ingredients in the product called Leaky Gut Support. I specifically formulated Leaky Gut Support to give you the nutrition needed to support the healing of a damaged gut. Remember, this condition is very common. It's at the root, you know, of a lot of more visible problems. And of course, leaky gut, you know, while a serious condition, is better than leaky butt. All right, I'll see you in the next video.